God. Come listen, read. If any man defile the temple of God, him shall God destroy.
Read it again from the top.
If any man defile the temple of God,
from the top.
Know ye not that ye are the temple of God?
Kevin, old school, you are the temple of God. Your body is the temple of God. Not a church. Your body are the temple of God. Read.
And that the Spirit of God dwelleth in you.
You see yourself on that sign, Kevin? Where at? American, Black, West Indian, Haitian, what? American, Black. You from the tribe of Judah, the same tribe as Christ.
That's right.
The Spirit of God naturally dwells in the Israelites. You are an Israelite. Old school. You are an Israelite according to the Bible. Read.
If any man defile the temple of God.
Kevin, old school. You defile this body that God gave you, there are repercussions. Stop right there. You know how you defile this temple? Kevin, stay with me. Kevin, stay with me. You know how you defile this body that God gave you? By smoking cigarettes, by smoking weed, by sleeping around, by getting tattoos, by worshiping other gods. Those are the ways that you defile this temple. Eating unclean foods, eating pork, eating shrimp, eating catfish. That's how you defile this body that God gave you. Now, I'll give you an example. If you're in a neighborhood and there's a building that's run down, it's about to fall over, what is the city gonna do to that building? They gonna what? They're gonna blow it up. They're gonna tear it down. It's the same thing with God. If you defile your temple, old school, God is gonna tear that down. That's why it's cancer in the earth. That's why you got people getting cancer in their liver. That's why you got people dying from smoking cigarettes 22 years, 15 years. Smoking since they was two. That's judgment from God, Kevin. So old school, we cannot smoke cigarettes. Why? Read on.
If any man defile the temple of God, him shall God destroy.
If we defile this body that God gave us, he is going to destroy it. He has no more use for it. Deuteronomy 28, verse 61.
Bring it out.
Y'all can act like y'all don't hear his word, but you hear. We know the areas that we come to when it's like this. Everybody in La La Land, they living good. They got their nice big house on the hill. But you don't know who you are. They got a saying that the old heads used to say, if you don't know where you've been, you don't know where you're going to go. Read.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28. Verse 61. Also, every sickness and every plague which is not written in the book of this law, them will the Lord bring upon thee until thou be destroyed.
Read that again.
Also, every sickness and every plague.
So, Kevin, my sister with the yellow hair wrap, old school, every sickness and every plague. A plague is a disease. So every sickness, every illness, every disease, read.
Which is not written in the book of this law.
My sister, is COVID-19 written in the Bible? No. Kevin, is COVID-19 written in the Bible? No, it's not. It don't say thou shalt catch a COVID. But we know instances where plagues was gonna happen. But we talking about specifically, do it say COVID? No, it's syphilis written in here. It's talking about what's written, what's on the page, what's written. No. But what? Read.
Also, every sickness and every plague which is not written in the book of this law, them will the Lord bring upon thee until thou be destroyed.
Every sickness, every illness, every disease which is not written in this Bible, God will put it on the Israelites until they be destroyed. Why? You're probably like, wait a minute. They feel like God picking on us. It's not picking on us. We are God's chosen people. What you must understand, God made an agreement with the Israelites a long time ago. Deuteronomy 28, verse 15.
Bring it out.
The agreement was this. If you listen to me, I'll bless you, give you everything you want. If you disobey me, I'm going to make your life hell. I just made it plain for you. You disobey me, you will receive curses. I will make life hell for you. When you look at the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, our life is hell. It's not because we got the short end of the stick. It's because we refuse to listen to God.
Right.
If y'all have children, do you have children, sis? Grandkids, nieces, nephews? What about you, Kevin? You got children? You got nieces? If your sister or your brother, whoever their parent is, give them rules. Be in the house at 9 o'clock. If they don't come in at 9 o'clock, it's a punishment. Am I right or am I wrong? So, it's the same thing with us. God gave us rules and regulations. He said, you wake up, you'll receive punishment. If you follow them, you'll receive rewards. Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15.
Listen up.
But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
If you want to know why the blacks and Hispanics always have it hard, now is your time to come listen. My brother, come get a flyer. Come get a flyer. Read that part again.
But it shall come to pass.
In the future, Moses said in the future. He's telling you what's going to happen in the future. Read.
If thou will not hearken.
If you do not listen to God, blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans, if you don't listen to God, read.
Unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments.
If you don't listen to God and do everything he said, read.
And his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses,
curses are bad things. He said all these bad things, read.
Shall come upon thee.
Will come upon us, Kevin. Will come upon us, old school. Read.
And overtake thee.
I'll give you some examples of curses. Verse 16.
Verse 16. Cursed shalt thou be in the city.
Kevin, when we were cursed in the city way back when, this is what would happen to you. If you ran away, they whipped your back into the point. Your scars healed, and it looked like a tree was on your back. Look at that brother back. That's a curse. That happened in every city in America. That's why it blows my mind how people think they in paradise. You living in the same place where they lynched your great-great-grandfathers at. Where the Ku Klux Klan chased you from city to city. Where they murdered Emmett Till in this very land. But you think you in heaven. Read.
And cursed shalt thou be in the field.
Cursed shalt thou be in the field. When were we cursed in the field? When we was picking cotton, sugar cane, tobacco. That's when we was cursed in the field. When we was picking their crops, managing their animals, their livestock. That's when we was cursed in the field. Read it again.
Cursed shalt thou be in the city.
You know what? You know how we cursed in the city today, Kevin? Old school, you know how we cursed in the city? We cursed in the city how? We are the only race of people that they can shoot down and not give an explanation why they did it. They can literally blow your head off and not give any reason. They can say they feel for their life. They get fired from the job, without pay. And then they get sent on their way. They move somewhere else to become an officer again. We are the only people that happens to. How else are we cursed in the city? Anywhere in this earth, the blacks and Hispanics live in the lowest conditions.
Bring it up.
Don't tell me about a famous Hispanic person. A famous black person. We talk about our people as a whole. Wherever we live in the worst environment.
That's right.
Pissy hallways. Rat infested. Roach infested. Food deserts. Right now, I can look around Rock Island and tell it's probably a couple miles before we see a grocery store. That's a food desert.
Right.
You supposed to have a grocery store in your neighborhood. That's how you know we cursed. In Chicago, people got to catch bus, train, probably an Uber to get to the damn grocery store to get their groceries.
Yep.
Then do the same commute back home. That's a curse. That's how we curse today in the city. You know how else we curse in the city? Read it one more time.
And curse shall thou be in the city.
Who do you look over your shoulder for late at night when you go into the ATM? Is it the white man who your real oppressor is, or is it the young man of today? It's the young men. The young men. Your own children that some of y'all gave birth to are terrorizing you. It ain't just Chicago, it's in the suburbs too. Blowing each other's brains out, robbing each other, robbing the elderly. That's how we cursed in the city, our own children terrorizing us. That's how you know we are the people of the book. Curse shall thou be Wells.
And curse shall thou be in the field.
Curse shall thou be in the field. How are you cursed in the field? How many black folks got these big jobs and you still can't pay your rent? You still can't pay for your child's tuition. You still struggling, but you making $30 an hour. Why is that? Cursed shalt thou be in the field. Why is it happening? Because we refuse to listen to God.
Right.
Stop doing things your way. Your way don't work. Try God's way.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission. Minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road. Purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.